We'll do a workshop about single sign-on, and we'll discover how the product LemonAdAppNG works. I will not do a presentation of this product today because we have a conference on Wednesday to discover the product and some feature like second factors or access control. So you will try the product before knowing how it works. It's how we made the LDAPCon. So first you have the workshop, and after you will discover what is this product. You can find the workshop on GitHub on this URL. You will need a VirtualBox image like this morning. So you can download it, but it's a free gigabyte. So I have some USB keys if you want to copy it from USB. I can give it here and here. So you can share these keys. And I have a third key here. And please copy the images, which is called LDAPCon 219.
Sorry.
Yes.
Can we also use the other virtual machine? Is there lots of things pre-installed on that one?
You are some LDAP expert here. You can, if you want, install yourself the OpenLDAP directory. Here is a sample things that I already installed on the image. The image has it runs on Debian 10, the latest stable Debian. So you made some CentOS this morning. You will do some Debian this afternoon. Okay. And I have an OpenLDAP running on this machine, and also I deployed an LDAP software which is Fusion Directory, which is already installed with some schema. This product is not mandatory to run the workshop, but if you prefer to use Apache Directory Studio, you can, or if you want to use a Korean LDAP browser, you can also give a try. This product is just a sample PHP interface that allows to see the content of the directory. The VirtualBox images is hosted on internet. So if you don't have the patience to wait for the key, you can also download it, or if you want to share the link to the people. I choose to run a graphical interface on this virtual machine because we will need to configure some DNS stuff to be able to access a virtual host. If you know how to configure Apache, you can, of course, run your browser from your host machine and access to the virtual host on the virtual machine. It will need to have a bridge configured interface on your network to be able to call the HTTP server from your host machine to your virtual machine. If you don't want to mess up with the network part, you can just run the virtual image inside VirtualBox, and we will run an HTTP browser inside the VirtualBox. So we will just call localhost from our image to run the software. What is the goal of this workshop? First, is to install the software, but it is very easy, we will see it. By default, LemonAdAppNG is not configured to use the LDAP authentications, but we are here at LDAPCon, so we will use OpenLDAP as an authentication backend. It means that you will be able to have user accounts in your OpenLDAP directory, and you will be able to log with this OpenLDAP accounts inside the Lemon LDAP portal. We will protect some web applications because the goal of Lemon LDAP is to give access to web applications and to, to control authentication and authorization to the web applications. So we will mostly do web this afternoon, and not we will not use low-level LDAP because Lemon LDAP is aimed to protect web applications. And the last point will be to enable second factor authentication. So maybe you already know what is it. Does someone know what is second factor authentication? Maybe everybody, but some people are shy and they don't want to raise their hand. So I choose to use TOTP with an application on the mobile phone. I hope everyone has a mobile phone. Maybe you already have some OTP application on your mobile phone. If you don't have it, there are free applications either on Google Store or on F-Droid for people who are using the F-Droid open source application store. You can use free OTP, free OTP Plus, or any OTP software. We will see that after. So when you have the virtual image, you just need to import it inside VirtualBox, and you should have something like this. And you should be able to log. The password is password. And you should be able to have a graphical desktop from which we will run a console, and we will be able to start the workshop with the console. The password is password, yes. I think it was easy, but when I say it, maybe too complex to say password is password. And login is not login. Login is Vortex. You have all the login and passwords written in the GitHub page. You see here, login Vortex and password. This is only to log in on the graphical interface, and then we can open a console. And you should be able to, you can open a console either from here or with Alt F2. And the root password is password 2. If you don't want to use a virtual image, like we say with Peter, you can, if you want, use any Linux image or your own laptop. With Lemon LDAP, we have packages for Debian, Ubuntu, and CentOS Red Hat. So you can follow the workshop by installing any of these. Maybe all commands will not work the same way between CentOS and Debian, but the product is fully compatible with both of these operating systems. Maybe a quick poll before. Does anyone already used Lemon LapNG or install it? Yes, one, two people, just two, three. Okay, thank you. So great for all the other people. This will be a discover. You may know that Lemon LapNG was released maybe 15 years ago, and last year we have a big release, which is 2.0, which brings up some very new feature. I will present this new feature Wednesday. But one of these brand new feature is second factor authentication. It's brand new in the product. Before this version, we could do it by hacking a little the product. Now it's really standard inside the product. And we will use our mobile phone today, but you can use any second factor medium. You can send short messages, you can send mail, you can have token. Maybe some of you have UBK to run a second factor. So all of this means can be used with Lemon LDAP. If you are here, you should be able to do some checks on the Open LDAP server. As I am a contributor of LDAP Toolbox project, I decided to install the LDAP Toolbox version of Open LDAP. Does anyone know what is the LDAP Toolbox project? Yes, Peter, of course, a great supporter of LDAP Toolbox. And it's just a packaged version of Open LDAP, which comes without any patch. So if you take the package from Debian or from Red Hat, you will have the Open LDAP software with some patches from the distributions. Here we just pull the Open LDAP source code and we build it inside package. And of course we add some things. So you should be able to see that the Open LDAP server is running. And I also installed LDAP VI. I imagine some of you know this tool. You will just run an editor to access the configuration and the data. This is not the only way to have it. You can do a Slapcat. If you are familiar with Slapcat, you can do what you want. And I choose to do the same config mode for configuration, which is not the problem because we will not update the Open LDAP configuration during this workshop, but you can have a look to the configuration directly inside here. There is no slapd.conf file. All the configurations that I used to build up this server is available on the Git repository, so you don't need it. But if you want to recreate the Open LDAP server like I did it, you can just use the config file that is here. So you can see we have a status here, and you have some backup and restore commands. It is not mandatory to run them, but you can just check that it works. Sorry?
Ah, you don't
run sudo, you just run su, su, to become super users. I did not configure sudo to be able to run the command. Just su, and you keep the password, and you are root. Okay, and then when you are root, all the commands will be run as root. So So if you want to play with this command, you can try a backup, which will create an LDF backup of your data. You can also backup the configuration. This is not the goal of this workshop, but you see that you have some extra commands here. What you should try now is to run the Fusion Directory software. If you are able to connect to the OpenNLAP server, you should click on this link in a new window, and you should... it's not working for me because I did not configure it. The workshop is already done for me. You should see this screen and log in. If you connect to localhost, you should be able to see this interface. Maybe you know PHP LDAP admin. It's an enhanced version of PHP LDAP admin. With your LDAP directory, you should have only one user, which is the administrator. So you log in with fdadmin, and the password is still password. So you should be able to see that. Does someone already know Fusion Directory? Do you already seen this interface? Okay. We are working a lot with this because it's quite simple to install. It's written in PHP. And people from this product are working on the PHP LDAP library. If you don't like the graphical interface, you still can use your command line, because you can do LDAP add or LDAP modify or LDAP search if you don't want to use it.
Maybe I missed a step. I cannot log in to the Fusion Directory.
You use the fd-admin login?
Okay.
FD, like Fusion Directory, and you should be the administrator of the interface. So the administrator can modify everything inside the directory. We will see, for the moment, we have only users. You have the configuration, you have some dashboards. So you should be able to modify the description, for example. Here. Okay. So it was the It was the easy part because you have nothing to install for the moment. So we imagine we are in an organization which already has this its own LDAP directory, and your mission is to install a single sign-on software to be able to connect web applications to your main authentication, and your main authentication into your LDAP directory. Of course, the first step of this kind of project is not to use web single sign-on, it's to configure your web application to check credentials directly on LDAP server. So a lot of applications can be configured today to connect to your LDAP directory, and then the users will log in with their LDAP passwords and will be logged in the web application. But in this case, they have to log to every web application with their login and password. So what we will do today is to configure Lemon LDAP so the authentication with the password will be done only one time. It's a single sign-on. And then you will be authenticated on other web applications without the need to enter your password on the other applications. Has anyone succeed to log in inside the Fusion directory? No? Sorry. Wait, okay, it's okay. If you have a problem, no problem? Okay. Okay. So with the English keyboard, all is very easy. That's a lesson from me today. Are you ready to install the product? We will do the installation and try to connect to the portal, and then we will see how to configure the product and to plug applications. So to install the product, you just need to create this file and to enter this content. So I let you do that. You should have this. Here we are setting the 2.0 versions. In our package repository, we fixed the main version, so if you do some upgrades, you will not switch to the next major versions. You will always be in the current major versions. If you replace 2.0 by stable keyword, you will be on the stable version, but when the stable version will be the next major version, you will automatically switch to the next major version. And this will require some work to adapt configuration to the next major version. So today the major version is 2.0. So you can just enter this. There is a command to get the GPG key, and then with an apt update you should be able to contact. Here you should be able to contact the repository. Then you install this software, and you notice that this software is written in Perl. But no panic, we don't have to do Perl today. We just install Perl. For this workshop, I choose to run it with Apache web server. You have to know that the product is also compatible with Nginx and other web servers. So So if you don't like Apache, you can also deploy LemonAdapng with other web server. So you just need to follow the installation process. And if you are familiar with Apache Debian packaging, you may know that Debian has some internal commands that are used to enable or disable configuration on a virtual host. So if you look on the file system, you can see that we have a repository with sit availables and sit enables. And Debian is creating symbolic links between the enable repository and the available repository. So these commands are just here to enable sit, and we also need these modules in LemonAdap. So this will enable all Apache modules. We should just have to copy paste these commands inside console to run them. And here we have a command to enable a check time, which is a specific option in LemonAdap to bypass the configuration cache. Why I need this is because we are doing a workshop and we will do a lot of configuration today. So if you want that the configuration is applied directly, we will say that LemonAdap will check every second if a new configuration is here. In production, you don't have to change the configuration often, and you don't want that the process check your database or your LDAP directory every second. So this is not for production, it is just for our workshop. With this option, with when at each second we will load the new configuration. So if you want that, you can check the Apache configuration and you can then restart Apache. And here is for people that think that this workshop is too easy. I don't. If it's too easy, you can make it harder by changing the default domain. We will work here with the example.com domain, but of course, when you install it for your organization, you will switch to a domain name that you own. So you can switch here the configuration, but if you do that, in all configuration commands that we will run later, you need to adapt, of course, the single sign-in domain to the new domain. So you're not forced to do it, of course. It's just an example. Apache should be installed by the above commands. It's not. If you done that, this should have installed Apache server with LemonAdap. Is anyone having trouble with Apache? Yes, Apache is not installed. By default, it should be a dependency of this command. So you should have. you should have this you should have this package installed. Who has the package installed? It was installed by default? It was a dependency. So you need to accept all the dependency when you run the software, when you install the software. So, if you install the software, we don't have any DNS server on the VirtualBox machine. So we will cheat a little and we will use the host file and say that these URLs will be resolved to the localhost. So it's very easy, you just have to edit tchost. And you should have this line. You should be able to ping auth example.com. And if this configuration is correct, and if the software was installed, you should be able to see this screen. You can switch the language here. Who manages to have this? Okay. Three winners. It doesn't take the password from the README. Oh. You should be able to log with Dr. Wu. Is that what you tried?
Yes, the
W184. Yes, and it has login and password?
It's wrong credentials.
Okay. Because this is the demo mode. When you install the software, there is a built-in login, and it should. Demonstrate. Okay, this means that
it's good.
Huh? It's good, yes.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And when you're on the interface. Because it's you are on the wrong.
This one.
You should use. You've done the.
I've done the listen thing for Apache, but I can also.
You switch the domain.
Yes, I'm accessing from the outside, but I try from the inside.
But because the Vortex is an existing domain, so you are connecting to the wrong server. You should edit your etc host to point to your machine. Yes. Well, with add to end site,
it's not in the path, the place where they are has been.
Okay. It's not in the path by default. Yeah. Maybe you have to exit and relog on the console.
Maybe I have
to update the path for add to end site.
Yeah. variables.
Ah, okay. Strange. No, it's not the good interface. You should not see this one. This one is not the demo interface. This is the production interface. You should see this image. If you choose to switch the domain here, you need to adapt this so the example.com is replaced by the domain. Here is what it was, my domain, but you can use any domain, okay? So adapt this like you cheat the DNS system, and you should see that. And you should be able to log with a user which is called Dehu and a password which is Dehu, which is of course Doctor Who, for people knowing the TV show Doctor Who.
So when I do that, it brings up another login screen that says Vortex.
Did you change the domain in the configurations? Yes, it was for expert users, so you choose to do that. If you read the exclamation point, if you do that, if you really want to do that, you need to adapt all commands. So where you find example.com in your commands, you need to switch to the chosen domain here. But as I said, this is not mandatory to run the workshop. It is only if you want to change it. I recommend not to do it if you don't want to have some issues. You can do the reverse command if you want to switch back to example. Else, if you switch to this, you just need to adapt here where you see example, you replace by your domain. I could have switched to ldap.com if I want. You can switch to any domain.
How do you reverse it?
You reverse with this. Just do this. But yes, you just need to set this one. Okay. You run the same command, but you switch back to the example.com with all the files behind. Sorry?
Minus I.
I should maybe remove this sentence from the workshop. So if you are on the example.com, you should be able to log inside the example.com and to use Dehu on Dehu. And you should be able to see the screen. You know the Doctor Who TV show?
It's resolved now, it now works, and I just blindly copied and pasted and stuff.
Okay.
Just to catch up. Okay. Lost some time in the layout thing.
Okay. So maybe I need to put more red on the sentence or to remove this from the workshop. Because I think you are expert, so I made some tricky comments. And if you are logging as Dr. Wu is the master, so you are able to go on the administrative interface, which is called the manager in Lemon LDAP. And you should be able to see this. Can you access to the manager?
Yes.
So this manager is a graphical interface, so we can configure everything on the product through this graphical interface. But for the workshop, I also put the command line commands. So we don't need this to run the workshop. You can see that on this interface, you have access to configurations. You can browse the configurations. For the moment, you are at the first configuration. You can also browse the sessions. You can see who is connected to your single sign-on software. And of course, you should be alone connected because you are inside a virtual machine. And you should only see the session of Dr. Wu, which is opened here. Here, myself, I'm connected with another user, but you should be able to see another. And you can see what is registered inside the single sign-on session. In the menu, you can switch the language if you want. You can go back to portal, and on the portal you can log out. So now we will use this, which is faster for you because you only have to copy paste the command and not to click inside the administrative interface. But all we do with the command line interface can be configured through the manager. So you should be able to run this command. It shows how you can set key and get keys for the configuration. With this, you can program how you install the software. We will see that we'll set up the LDAP authentication mode. And if you have to reproduce this configuration, you can copy-paste all the command lines, or you can also export and restore some configurations. So it's easy with any tools like Puppet and Cibl and so on Chef, you can easily configure the software. We will see how work test applications. So if you are here, you can enable this configuration and reload EPG. This is a really simple application if you want to see it. The only thing that is related to Lemon LDAP NG is this line. All the other lines are a standard Apache configuration. So if you have any software, we'll see it after. If you have any virtual host for another software, the only line you need to enable single sign-on on this virtual host is this one, because this will say, okay, when a request comes inside the virtual host, you will call the LemonAdap agent. So the agent is called the handler in LemonAdap. And it will process the request and see if you are authenticated. So if you comment this line, you disable the single sign-on. If you uncomment it, you enable the single sign-on. So just with these two lines, you should be able to connect to this test application. This command is just to have a look to the configuration. So if you are not logged, it will ask you to log. If you are already logged, you should see that you are authenticated. So how will the single sign-on works for this kind of applications? We will just send some HTTP headers to the application. The application will read the HTTP headers and know who is connected. There is no other protection. The only protection is that you enable this single sign-on configuration line inside the Apache virtual host. If you don't protect your application, anyone can log in by sending an HTTP header. So this agent handler must be installed on the web server where the web application is, or if you are using a reverse proxy, you must ensure that only the reverse proxy can access to the web application, because this is a reverse proxy which sends the HTTP headers, so you are protected with this. But if anyone can access to the protected application bypassing the reverse proxy, the security is messed up. You are forced to control this. Yes?
Does this require Apache.pro?
Sorry?
Does this require the pro module for the Apache
web server? Is this required?
The configuration line shown, this pro header parser, I think it's a directive from the pro module for the Apache web server.
The pro module?
Isn't it?
The question is it a custom, a known module of Apache 2? Is it a standard module from Apache 2? No,
that's not. Is the module a standard module of the Apache 2?
Ah, here it is not a module from Apache 2. The handler, the line that we are putting here,
yeah.
This one.
Yes.
This one is specific to LemonAdap. LemonAdap ng. It calls some code. It tells to Apache. Apache has an API, which is not a web service API. It's just a built-in API in ModPerl. Then you can tell Apache when you receive a request, before sending the request to the web application, you call this module. This module is the one we installed with LemonAdap. This module is called a handler. And this handler will check the request before the request gets to the web applications. Yes? Yes, we support Apache 2, Nginx, Light HTTPD, and every fast CGI web servers can be used. We have an agent for every web servers. We just don't support IIS from Microsoft. Yes?
Going back a bit, I'm about 20 minutes behind here.
Okay.
Sorry, I've only just got Apache to start.
Okay.
I log in as Dhu, and
yes.
It takes me to the Vertex site and asks me to log in again.
Ah, you are redirected to Vertex because you switched the domain to vertex.com. If you don't want to switch to Vertex, you can just set back the example.com. When you first do the sed command to switch. You can unswitch by running this to use the example.com domain. Just before the break, I would like that we apply a first configuration, which is how to connect to LDAP directory. So here you notice that we are in a demonstration mode, because of course the Dewoo login is built in. There is it is hard coded in the demo module. And now we want not to authenticate inside the demonstration module, but we want to use the LDAP directory to authenticate users. So to do this, we will have to configure the LDAP settings inside Lehman LDAP. So as you can see, we will use the command line interface, and we will apply all these settings in Lehman LDAP. So we choose to use LDAP as authentication, user database, and password database, which means how I authenticate the user, how I check the password. Okay. UserDB is how I get information from the user. Here I choose to read attributes from the LDAP directory. And PasswordDB is how I change the password for the user. Here I choose also to change the password inside LDAP directory. And RegisterDB is an option to be able to create accounts from the Lehman LDAP start page. If you want to allow people that don't have any account on your LDAP directory to enter their first name, last name, and they are able to auto-create an account on your LDAP directory to access the service. We often disable this because we don't want everyone to be able to create an account on the LDAP directory. But for some use case, you may want to let people create their account on your directory. Here you can notice the server, which account will be used to connect to the LDAP server, where are the users, and here, because we are LDAP experts, we will use the password policy control. Yes?
So manager DN, that's to like do a UID to DN lookup to get the DN?
This account is an application account, which will be used by Lehman LDAP NG to connect to your LDAP directory. So I don't want to use a root DN account. I don't want to set the manager account here. Because the manager, as you may know, the manager account of OpenLDAP has full rights on OpenLDAP. So I don't want that. I created what we call the directory service account. I don't know if you know this term. Directory service account is a technical account. It is not a user account. The users don't know this password. It's just a technical account that is already created inside your LDAP directory.
Yeah, but what's its purpose, though? I mean, what is it actually?
When you will enter your login inside Lehman LDAP, you will be forced to do a search on LDAP directory to check which account is linked to this login. So this account will do a search, will find if you are logged in. We do a lot of things with LDAP directory. We can read groups, so you can browse groups, LDAP groups, and find which groups are the group of the users, etc. So
I've noticed a lot of applications that use LDAP. You know, they either use a manager account or they can construct the DN.
Okay.
Some,
yes, you are right. Some applications have an option to construct the DN from the login, which is a bad practice, because you can't be sure that all user accounts will be in the same branch. You can't be sure of that. But in our case, it could work, because all my users are inside this branch. So I could have a configuration settings to say, okay, UID equal the login, comma, the user branch. But in Lehman LDAP, as in other LDAP tools, we just configure a search branch, and we say, okay, when you receive a login, you will search for for the login inside this branch. There is a default filter that is not configured here, but it is by default UID equals the login. Okay, I did not configure it here because this is the default value in the software. But you can configure it. So this is the default settings of your LDAP directory. And the other command is the list of attributes that I want to read from LDAP directory. And these attributes will be saved inside a single sign-on session. So you log in, you read the user entry on the LDAP directory, you save these settings inside the user sessions, and when they are saved, you are able then to pass this information to connected applications. So if you are here, I propose that you copy-paste these two commands, and then as we switch from the demo mode to the LDAP mode, you should be able to log in with the fdadmin account and password, because it is the LDAP account that is already existing in your LDAP directory. And if you do that, you can have a break. If you can't do that, sorry for you. Anyway, I'm here to help you. If you want to have a break, I can help you to have a break.
How do we log out?
How do you, you can, yes, you can log out here, yes. You can log out with a button, or you have the URL hot.example.com/logout. Which will run the logout process. So I propose you to update the access rules of the manager. You see here that we are using some access rules inside Lehman LDAP. This is how Lehman LDAP can control who can access to the applications. And one of these applications is the administrative interface of Lehman LDAP. So you don't have to understand this. It is just a command to copy and paste to delete all the previous rules that we set up in the default Lehman LDAP installation to protect. Hello? Hello? Okay.
Maybe the battery?
I think there is no battery. Okay. So it was just the rules that we defined by default in Lehman LDAP. So you can delete them. Here we delete this case and we add this one. We set the default access rules to this one. If you are not familiar with regular expression, don't be afraid. It is just to say that we want that the UID value begin with fdadmin and end with this one. So it will just mean that only fdadmin account can access to the manager. So if you do that and that, you can then log in with fdadmin, and you can see that the fdadmin account has access to the manager because we change here the rules, the access rules. It is not mandatory. If you don't want to do this, you can also edit the .ini file, which is a main Lehman LDAP configuration. You can override in this file any configuration setting. If you edit this one, you must restart Apache 2 because this file is only read when Apache is starting. So you can choose any of this solution, but just copy-paste this. And then we will see how to configure Fusion directory in a web single sign-on. If the commands are okay, you should be able to see the administration's applications here. And you should be able to connect as fdadmin to the manager. So Fusion Directory is not a software linked to Lemon LDAP, it's a standalone software, and it proposes by default to connect to single sign-on software with two methods, one with HTTP headers and the other with CAS, which is another protocol. We will use the HTTP headers here because we already set up some application with this. So the first things to do is to create an Apache virtual host. For this, you just have to copy-paste what is written in this tutorial. You create, this file does not exist, so you will create it, and you will put inside this content. So you see, it's very easy. I just set up the document root to the Fusion directory, and I just enabled here the agent of Lemon LDAP to check the single sign-on. So if you create this file with this, you should be able to enable it and reload Apache. To check which virtual host are enabled, you can use the Apache CTL command, and it will show you that this file is enabled for this virtual host. Of course, as we created a new name, we will trick the DNS and we will add it inside our host file so we can resolve it. So you just need to add this in your host file. When you've done that, and you can to try then to access to this host, but it should not work. So try first to create this virtual host. It's a really simple Apache configuration for people already doing Apache. And enable it. And don't forget to edit your host file. So you can see here my host file. So at this step, Apache is configured to serve the fd.example.com virtual host, but Lemon LDAP software is not configured to serve it. To do this, you must declare this virtual host inside Lemon LDAP. So here we are setting three lines of configuration. The first is the location rules, so it's how to access to the software. We will say that by default, every connected user will be accepted. The second line is a regular expression to catch the logout process. So when Lemon LDAP will see that a user is calling this URL, we will trigger a single sign-on logout. So it will be disconnected from the application and it will be disconnected from the single sign-on software. And the last line is just the configuration of the HTTP header which is sent to the web applications. So here we only send one HTTP headers, and we put in the auth user HTTP header the value of the UID of the user. If you do this, you should be able to access to this software. But we do not finish the configuration because Fusion Directory is not configured on its side to trust the single sign-on software. So here we configure Apache 2 to define the virtual host. Here we configure Lemon LDAP, the single sign-on server, to allow a connection on this virtual host. And then we will configure the web application to enable the single sign-on process. This is done graphically inside the Fusion Directory. So to do that, you connect to Fusion Directory and you can access to configurations, and you see here that there are options. So the edit button is hidden in the bottom right of the window. So you need to click on edit. And you need to check the box to enable HTTP header authentication. This is the only configuration needed for Fusion Directory. When you save it, you will have enabled the single sign-on of the software. Of course, every product has a different way to configure the single sign-on. What we see for Apache and Lemon LDAP, the command we see, you can reproduce them to configure any other product, but the client side is like when you configure an application to connect to an LDAP directory. Each application has its own parameters to connect to an LDAP directory. So each application has its own parameters to connect to a single sign-on software. So we are lucky with Fusion Directory, because in Fusion Directory there is just one checkbox, because we already send the good HTTP header name here. And when you do that, you should be able to connect. You have the Fusion Directory virtual host setup. If it's well enabled, you should be able to check the authentication box on Fusion Directory, sign out, and reconnect. You should be connected without any password prompt. Of course, we have the password prompt from Lemon LDAP, but you don't have anymore the password prompt from Fusion Directory. Is it working for somebody? Or I am the only one to have a setting? Okay, it's working. As you know, we still have a direct access to the Fusion Directory interface, which is still available on localhost/fusion-directory, which is the default installation of the software. As I previously said, if I connect to localhost/fusion-directory, and if I forge an HTTP headers, I will be able to log in inside Fusion Directory without any password, because Fusion Directory is configured to accept an HTTP header as an authentication proof. So if we do that, we need to disable the direct access, so we can only access Fusion Directory through the Lemon LDAP ng agent. In Debian, it is very easy. It is just a matter of disabling the configuration of Fusion Directory. So if you disable this, you cannot access to Fusion Directory with http://localhost/fusion-directory. Another point is the application in menu. You see that in Neman LDAP we have a small application menu, and what we want is to have a little logo here so we can click on it to access to the application. This is another configuration part of Neman LDAP. You have here a sample. You see that we can get the application list, so it is just for information, you don't need to do that, just to show you that the CLI can get some values. So we choose to register the icon inside the sample category, and we will put all these options. So you see the description, the logo, the name, and the URL. This one is a configuration that will display the icon only to people who have the right to access it. So when you connect to the application menu, you only see the icons that are linked to applications on which you have the access. If you don't have access to the application, the menu will hide the application. You can choose in Neman LDAP to always show an application or to always hide it. But by default, we only show an application to a user if the user can access it. So when doing this, you should have the Fusion directory entry inside the application menu. You notice it's just for graphical purpose because without the icon in the menu, you still can access to the application. So here I have my icon, and here I'm connected to the web application. Is everyone at this step, or is it too fast? Are you lost completely? No? Are you too tired? No, okay. If you want, I will go through the workshop to show you all the commands. If you don't manage to copy paste them on the fly, it's not a matter. You will see how it works. And the next steps is to create a new account. You can use any LDAP software to create a new account. Of course, you can use LDAPPad. You can use Apache Directory Studio. If you want to try Fusion Directory, you can create your own account inside it. You just go on user and then you will be able to create a new account. I'm here, and in action I can create a user. So for example, I create it in clear text because I have a password policy enabled on OpenLDAP, and it will refuse the SSL password. So here, I have a new account. If I open a private window, you should be able to connect with this new account. So Very easy. You have a new account in your LDAP, a login, a password. You can connect with this login and password inside Lemon LDAP. So, when you have this account, what we want is to enable a second factor authentication for this account. For this, to be able to test it, you need an application on your phone. If you don't have one, I suggest this one, but you can use any TOTP application. Google Authenticator is a TOTP application, for example. So you just have to install it on your mobile. For the server part, we need another third module. You just install it like this, and then we are able to configure the second factor authentication part. Here is a choice that I made for this configuration. So we enable the self-registration. It means that a user can self-register his passcode. You can have some organization where the user don't have the choice. The code is set up by the administrator, and the user just have to use it, but he can't initialize it. Here we want to be able to initialize it. And then we will associate an authentication level to this second factor. So we will say that if we connect with second factor, we have the 5 authentication level, and we'll see that we can give access to application only to people with a good authentication level. So we want 6 digits, etc., etc. To configure this, you just have to copy-paste these settings. It will enable the second authentication part inside Lemon LDAP. So please install the library here and set this. And if you set it, you should be able to have a new menu here inside Lemon LDAP. You have the second factor manager, and you should be able to access this screen. And what we notice is a QR code. So this is my private key, which is displayed as a QR code, because with your mobile application, you will be able to scan this code, and it will register the private key inside your phone. And then you will have a match between the private key stored inside your single sign-on session and the private key stored inside your mobile phone. So if you scan this one, you will scan my private key. Okay, so you will be able to log in with my second factor. You should be able to have your own code displayed on Lemon LDAP, and this code will register the private key on your mobile application. When it is registered, to confirm that the association is made, you will generate a temporary code, enter it here, and you will register it. This will allow you to verify that you will register the private key. So if I doing it with my smartphone, I have an application like this. It's small because I do scan code. And here I have a new application which is created. And if I click on it, I have some numbers which are the temporary code. So I will enter these numbers. Register. I was too long. I need to scan it. Okay. So my key is registered. I can go to portal. Now if I log out, and if I try to log in again, now the software knows that I registered the second factor. So to enter, I need to generate a code and enter this code. So I'm logged in with a second factor with my mobile phone. And if I need it, I can remove this second factor or generate a new one. Any question about this? Yes?
I think I missed a piece. What app do you have on your phone to do this?
What do I have to have on my phone is an application. There are several applications that are that can be used to do TOTP, because TOTP is a standard. So you have Google Authenticator, but you have some open source application as FreeOTP or FreeOTP Plus. You can install any of them. It will be a store of your private keys. And a private key is used to generate a code that only lasts by default 60 seconds. So if someone steals your password, he can't log in because he needs also your phone with the application and with the secret key inside your phone. But if you lose your phone, you cannot log in anymore. That's why an administrator can reset the second factor for you, so you will be able to log in again and generate a new one. And if you change your phone, that things that I've done recently, you need to export your private keys to re-import them in your new phone to be able to log in again, else you will lose all your second factors. A lot of applications today are compatible with second factors. You can go on Twitter and enable second factor. You can go on LinkedIn. You can go on GitLab, on GitHub. Yes. The advantage here is that you configure it on the main authentication portal. So all your applications linked to Lemon LDAP no benefits from second factor authentication. You can see that in a Fusion directory, for example. There is no second factor authentication possible. But if you connect Fusion directory to Lemon LDAP and if you enable second factor on Lemon LDAP, you got second factor on Fusion directory. That's the goal of this. So it's a little quick, but you just have to copy paste this command and it will enable the second factor. The interesting part then is that you can enable or disable access to application for users that don't have any second factor. To do this, you see that we will test here this application to test2.example.com. We will see, configure it to check the authentication level. So by default, to access to this virtual host, my rule is that authentication level should be superior to 4. We don't see it, but when you log in only with login and password with LDAP, you are at level 2. So if you log in with login password and second factor, we set it to 5. So with this rule, we should be only able to access to test2.example.com with second factor. I can show you in the manager, because in the manager we have the same values that in the command line. So you see that this default rule is here. What we set with the command line interface is the same that we can see in the graphical interface. It's just another representation of the configuration. So this is set as default rule for test2.example.com. And what I can see is, you see that two sessions are opened. My administrator has no second factor, so its authentication level is 2. But this one has an authentication level of 5. You see that an OTP is registered for him, but not here. And we have a special administration menu to only display people with OTP, and you see that if I am an administrator, I can remove the OTP from the user. So if I go on the portal, I see that I don't have the test2.example.com. If I try to go on it, access is refused. Okay, but if I with the other session, I see that I have the icon, and if I go on it, and I have the access to it. So here we have a simple access rule depending on the authentication level. And you see that the protected application has nothing to do with the authorization. The protected application does not know if there is an access rule or not. All the authorizations are managed by Lemon LDAP, by the agent that is enabled inside the Apache configuration. And the request can only access the protected application if the user is authorized. So you can prevent any access to the application to people without second factor, for example. So if you follow the configuration step, you should be able to have the same result on your virtual machine. Okay. If you want to go further, I made some small documentation with DocuWiki, which is a well-known open source wiki software, just to show you that a lot of well-known applications are already compatible with single sign-on. So it's just for information. You can see here that I installed DocuWiki from the default Debian package. And then you see, like Fusion Directory, we have access on localhost. but we will be able to configure it to accept single sign-on. So like I've done before with Fusion Directory, I created the DocuWiki virtual host. And then I set this as configuration. Here DocuWiki expects three HTTP headers, one for the login, one for the command name, and one for the email. This is not Lemon and LDAP who decided this. This is the DocuWiki team who writes a Lemon LDAP plugin. They said in the documentation that they expect these three headers. So you just need to configure them. And when you configure them, you can, here, you just search Lemon LDAP in the extension manager of DocuWiki. You enable it. And then you can be connected to DocuWiki. So it's just another example if you want to practice how to connect an application inside the single sign-on software. You can connect it, and you can see on the Lemon LDAP website a lot of applications like GitLab, like WordPress, like a lot of applications can be connected to Lemon LDAP to do the single sign-on. For DocuWiki, for example, you see I'm logged in directly inside DocuWiki without any password because I'm already authenticated on the single sign-on software. The interesting part of this is that you don't have to do user provisioning because a lot of products like DocuWiki will auto-create a user account for someone who's coming from the single sign-on software. So it is my first connection to the software, but as there is a trust between DocuWiki and Lemon LDAP, DocuWiki has auto-created an account for this user. So you don't have anything to do. A new user is registered inside your Open LDAP directory. It connects, and then it can access to any applications. And of course, you can enhance the security with a second factor. Yes?
Just backing up a moment. A couple of minutes ago, showed clearing a second factor from a user that had lost their device.
Yes.
But I don't think that's described in the notes. Can you just...
Yes, the question is...
I said
we can, as an administrator, you can reset a second factor for a user. And it is a bonus because it is not written in the doc. So to do this, you just have to be admin and to access to the manager interface. So I will access to the manager, and you can see that you have a menu at the right which is named second factor. And if you have some user with a second factor, it only shows users that already had a second factor registered. And here you see that this one has a second factor. And you can see that here, I will do it. It is reset. So if I connect back, I will log out here and log in again. Okay, no second password asked because it was deleted, but I see that I no more have access to the test2 application because the access was only given to people with a second factor. So if I want to access to test2, I need to regenerate a second factor, register it on my phone, and then I will be able to log in again, enter the second factor, and I will be granted to level 5, and with this level 5, I will be allow to access to all applications that are protected with a rule based on authentication level. And the mobile phone is just one of the possibilities we have with second factors. As I said at the beginning, we can use a YubiKey, for example. You can send a short message on the mobile phone. You can send a mail. You can use any second factor token to allow second factor authentication.
Is it just one per user? Because I just tried with two different TOTP applications. It wouldn't let me register the second one.
It is not allowed in the default configuration, but you can have a configuration in Lehman LDAP. Sorry, I will repeat the question. The question is, can we have multiple second factor for one user? The answer is yes. You need an additional parameter to allow a multiple instance of second factor. And in this case, you can have multiple TOTP second factor, for example, and register it inside many applications. And you can also enable the second factor with a rule. You can have a rule that says, okay, you're from a foreign IP, so I detect your IP, and if you are from this IP, I ask you a second factor. But if you are from the internal network, I don't ask you the second factor. You can have some rules like this. You can do a lot of complex things with the software. Okay, that was the end of the workshop material. If you have any question, if there is some issues in configuration, I'm here to help. And there will be a small speech about Lehman LDAP and all other features of Lehman LDAP Wednesday inside the talk sessions. So you can also ask new questions Wednesday. I hope this was not too complex. I think we are all a little tired. So if anyone, if no one has any question, well, we can finish the workshop now. Anyway, well, thank you. Congratulations. And see you tonight or tomorrow. Thank you.